Good morning, everyone. We're going to paint over coffee this morning. So we're going to continue our piece. This is part four, I believe. If I tried to upload this all into one video, it would be like 4 or 5 hours. So it's best to just break it up in hour increments, so you guys can come back and watch as you would like. Right now I'm just organizing all my tools into order. All right, all done. Again, I'm using the white mandala, do-it-yourself mandala stone dotting tools that you can find on Amazon, link in the description. I am using Vivid Enamel Tintable Paint Base. 1/2 ounce goes into one of these cups right here that I get on Amazon. They have a nice little lid, protects your paint, keeps them fresh for quite some time. If they're sitting more than 2 to 3 days, please make sure you stir. I'm getting me some Q-tips out, that way I don't have to reach across you guys. When you mix these two together, you're going to use about 1/8 of a scoop, which looks like, I know we go over this every video, but in case you're watching the later videos and not the front videos, it's about that much. And you can always tell if your paint is not tinted enough as you lay your dots, because you'll see, you'll notice it looks different. And I would suggest laying down some test dots before you start on your piece, so you know you've got the right consistency. Just a little tidbit I can offer you. Get my water ready. All right, so we are going to go and put the swishes on now. And then we're going to put the top dots on, and hopefully by the time we do that, we can come back and put top dots on these, and maybe this will be the last video on this piece. So we are going to get started. Have my little trusty rag here to wipe off my tool, my toothpicks to stir my paint. This lovely little toothpick holder has worked out great. It's also in the description below, a link to Amazon and where to find it. Okay, because we're going to start with Baltic Amber. And today we're going to drag the dots down to the center of the piece. I think I really should add some more Baltic Amber to the jar. And again, this is Prism Pour, which is good on canvas, wood, metal, and glass. It's an acrylic paint, surface paint. Shake it. put your hands in it. I always do it. Never fails. Just give it a good stir to mix up some of that older paint with the fresh paint that you just put in. So now we're just going to find what dot works best to lay down. And then you kind of want to use a smaller tool to drag down your dots in. And we're probably going to use a number one for that. Possibly a number two, but the number one is a lot pointier. So it's going to allow you to shape your dot to perfection as you pull it down. So we're going to use a 1 on the drag. I'll put the 1 on the right side, and I'll put the dot on the left side. We don't want them to be too big. So let's see. I think a 13 would work best, because I want them to be a little smaller than these dots. Maybe we'll do a 14. That's pretty close. Uh-oh. There it is. Oh. See, as we're waiting for this part to dry, we can go back and top dot these and these. And by the time we get all that done, it should be done. I had to move that so you guys can see. So you lay your dot. You want to load it up pretty good, so you might need to double dot it. Now, you want to take your number one, and you want to drag it to the center. You can load up this tool and go back in and pull down the rest. And I think I'm going to switch tools from a number one to one of the Mark Mandala's tools, because they're easier to drag the dots with. You just want to manipulate the paint and try to get it to move where you want it. That looks pretty good there. I think I want the dot to come down just a little more. But I don't know, though. That's more of a precision line, and we really made it. We're going to stick with one. Now we need the Mayan gold. Remember, open your paints away from your piece, so those dry pieces do not get in there. I'm going to show you this as it pours in. I just got to get a hold of the cap so it doesn't get in my way. Take the other end of your Q-tip and mix it. get this paint all over me when I'm doing this. That's okay. It colors my world and colors my body at the same time. So now we want to lay a dot here. Load it up. We're going to take our number one tool. Drag your dot down and then fill it in. That one was a lot easier to fill in than that first one. Try not to get too messy with it. Try to stay in your lines. Now we're going to put a gold dot on the other side of it. Load it up. And see, I think I got it too much. Higher than the other, so now I've got to fix it. So wipe off your tool. There's cat hair. Dirty cats. They like to get up here and mess with my stuff in the middle of the night, so I have learned to try to put it up. I've got some gunk built up on this piece, so I'm going to take an alcohol wipe and just wipe it off because I don't want that coming off in my paint. Okay. And I think it would be better suited if I turn it around. We're going to put these on top of here so you can see what tools I am using. And we're going to turn it because it will be easier for me to do these if I turn it around. So I got to take this dot off. Remember, just roll your Q-tip in your paint and hope not to get it stuck on any of the others. Dip your paint in the water. And try to get as much of that off as you can. Without touching that other dot and messing it up. Now I'm just going to get in there nice and tight and try to get as much of that glitter out as I can. Okay. I'm going to pull this piece just a little bit closer to me because I can't really see it very well. And there's cat hair everywhere. Might be a good idea to shake my towel off before I start painting next time. bratty kitties. Okay. That's better. Load it up. I'm using a 14 for the baste, and then I'm using the 1 to drag it. Wiping off Rotul and going back to the Baltic Amber. Putting that cap on loosely. Going back to my 14. Loading up the tool. Using the 1 to drag it down. Remember, if you want to save 20% on any of the color art products, whether it be Prism Pour, Primary Element Art Pigments, Resin Pigments, use my code in the description below, LunaSky1121. Now we're coming over here to do another Baltic Amber dot on this side. I think that might be just a little too high. And I do want to come back in and get that little piece of gold that's missing when I hit the gold again. Take care of that gold before the other dries. So it's just as simple as loading up your tool and filling it in. And I want to put a little more paint around that edge there. See, this paint dries pretty quick, so it's easy to mess it up. It is very good that it dries quick because it allows us to continue our piece faster than a lot of the other paints, because in my experience, this is the fastest drying paint I have ever used while doing dot work. And I've tried Arteza, Metallics, color shifting, I've tried folk art. I've tried Montmartre, deco art. I tend to stay away from the Walmart brands, CraftSmart, I think is what it's called, because I've read a lot, you know, I watched a lot of YouTube videos when I was first starting out. And, you know, sometimes they're pretty good about telling you what paints work well and what paints don't. I tend to take their advice. This one's not wanting to drag down very good. There we go. What you're hearing is me like moving the paint over the record into those little grooves. Now we do the next section. Baltic amber in the center. Try to get them where you laid them down before in the previous. That's a little big, but we'll work with it. At that, because I'm not sure I like it. It's going at an angle. But I don't really see it. So we're going to continue on. Baltic amber, go back to the Mayan gold. This time we're going to try to work a little faster and lay down the dots at the same time. It's kind of like coloring to fill in these drag dots, and that's the way I think of it anyway. It's like working with a pencil, colored pencil. You know, and just be creative with your piece. You know, in the beginning, I always struggled, like, what am I going to lay down next? I found it doesn't really matter. Just do what you feel is right. What's jiving for you? It's supposed to be fun, not stressful, right? At least that's the way I try to look at it. Don't stress yourself out. It's supposed to be a peaceful, relaxing art. And as long as you load that dot, you should be able to drag it successfully. Moving right along. Moving back to Mayan gold. Looks like I've been pretty successful with loading up the dots twice and then dragging. Another darn cat hair. Yeah, I'm gonna have to have a talk with them. Yesterday we had the dog interrupting the video, and today the cats are taking precedence. I guess they got jealous. This could be a good ASML video, the sound that's coming off the record with the tool. Oh, look, more cat hairs. Dirty, dirty cats, I'm telling you. I don't know what I'm gonna do with them. I guess I'll keep them. Moving back to the Baltic Amber. not to mess this up where you throw it in your paints. I'm really dirtying up my tool, but that's okay. Piece of fuzz on it. This one. Sounds like I got them really fired up with throwing their little mice, toy mice, around this morning. They're in my living room wreaking havoc on something. To the Mayan gold. Remember, don't be afraid to push your paint around. You can always fix it if you need to. I think I've demonstrated that well while doing this piece. I've had to make many corrections. Some more. back to Baltic Amber. As you can see, we're only like a quarter of the way through, but we're getting there. Once this part's done, the rest will go fast. I used the wrong end, so I need to switch it over. When these get over to this side, I've really got to watch because I might put my hand in the paint, and I don't want to do that after working so hard on this part. Going back to Mayan gold again. Oops. And as you do it more and more, you'll get faster at it. I would suggest doing it slow in the beginning until you get the hang of it. Oh my gosh, when I first started out painting, dot painting, it was such a challenging process. So I sympathize with the beginners of the group. Remember, you know, anytime you have questions, don't hesitate to ask, you know, reach out, leave a comment. I will do my best to answer questions and provide additional instruction should you need it. There is literally a cat hair stuck to my tool. Oh, they are. Those cats are really playing this morning. Chirping at each other and running back and forth. Maybe you can hear their pitter-patter, I'm not sure. They're definitely enjoying themselves. As you can see, this piece takes a while to create. It's definitely worth it though. Such beauty in the colors. Very rich, shiny, shimmery. I like shiny things, I cannot lie. Some girls want diamonds. I just want color art. See, now we're getting close to where these dots are going to be in my, you know, coming around. So I want to be sure that I don't lay my hand down in the paint or my arm, which I have been known to do on several occasions. Now we're halfway through. When we get this done, we'll only have one more half to go. We might have to load our little jars again with paint, because this does take up quite a bit of paint, these dragging the dots. Thank you. I'm going to bring you up for a close-up so you can really see how that gold, the golds blend, you know, mesh well with each other. It's shimmery, so shimmery. To the Baltic Amber. Okay, so we're getting close. Now I'm going to touch this dot and see how, see, we've made it around to here, and this set of dots is dry. And it's been about an hour. To the gold. Baltic amber again. Staying with the Baltic amber, going to the next section. Trying not to cast shadows over my piece with my left hand. To Mayan gold. You can usually tell when you don't lay your dots down right because they will look different than your other ones. You always want to make sure you're straight up and down when you're laying your dots. That can make a difference. Whereas you go in it sideways, your dots don't come out right. They're not full and round. I used to get so frustrated in the beginning of this art. Luckily, I had somebody to encourage me. Just keep going, you'll get better. Turns out, she was right. Because these pieces, compared to some of my first pieces, what a difference. I see my hand is over here, but those dots are dry, so I am good. I'm not picking it up on my arm. Back to the Baltic Amber. Size 14 tool to lay the dots down.
Sorry.
Trying to practice not resting my arm on the piece because we're getting close to that point. Sometimes you can use your little pinky as support, but you gotta be pretty good with your tool, and as you can see, I'm having a little bit of trouble trying to keep my balance there. Having peripheral neuropathy and vertigo doesn't help sometimes. Okay, so on these last three sections, I'm going to lay down all my Baltic Amber at once and then drag the dots, because this video is starting to get a little long and I want to be able to go back and do the top dots with you. Go ahead and wipe off that tool. Thank you. going back to Mayan Gold. I'm going to do two dots, the two dots in each section, and drag them and move it to the next section. Because what I found by spreading them out three was by the time I got to this one, it was already starting to dry. So, keep it simple. And make sure our paint stays wet as we try to work with it. One of the ladies that I used to watch YouTubes on to learn techniques in the beginning was Kristen Urig. She is an amazing dot artist. And she taught me a lot along the way, which I can use some of those techniques here and also teach you how to dot. I like to give credit where credit is due. We are almost there. Almost there. There's something in that one. All right. One more color around this ring, and we are moving on to top dots. Remember that at this point you've got wet paint to the right of your right hand, or your hand, whatever, whichever hand you're using, if you're following along, so you don't want to lay your hand down in it. And I think we're probably going to stop this video here and pick up with a different one on the top dots, because this one is already an hour and a half long. Set. I think I'm going to ask you guys to leave comments in the description below. Do you like the videos being this long, or would you rather me speed them up and then talk over the video as instructions? I'm not sure how people like it, because having a long video gives you a lot of detail that doesn't really get expressed when you're just going back over your video, speeding it up, and voicing over it. So you let me know in the comments below what you like best. And I will definitely take it into consideration. All right, that is it. I'll bring you up for a close-up in just a second. And then we will have another video on the remaining process. It's looking very good. As you can see how wet the paint still is on this side. But if you look over here, all of this is dry. I can run my, well, maybe not that one. But these, our first ones are. Make sure you don't have any cat hair in your pieces. But it's very shimmery and beautiful. Until next time, have a blessed day.